Good morning, class 8. Welcome to science. And today I want to take you through the vision. I'm starting with vision. Since you have finished the syllabus, remember, in class 8 you are supposed to look at 9 units, starting from the first one, human body, to the last one, making what is there. We are done with the syllabus. And now, having gone through syllabus, we need to embark on a revision to remind ourselves what we learned in previous classes. To start with, I'm taking the education. I'm starting on human body. And my first point on human body, I'll start on the education. Class 4, I'll just give you an assignment so that you can try them at home. Digestion, to start with, we need to define what is digestion. How do you define digestion? What is the meaning of the term digestion? Digestion simply means breaking down foods. The proper digestion is the breaking down of foods in small particles that can be absorbed. Is the breaking of food into small particles. That can be absorbed. Into the blood. Class 8, this is how we define digestion. This is the definition I want you to take. Digestion, we say, is the breaking down of food. You are breaking food into small particles purposely to enable this food to be absorbed easily. Remember, somewhere back in the law classes, we define digestion as the process of breaking down food into small particles that can be easily swallowed. Now here, we are not talking about swallowing only. We need to focus on the final part of digestion. Why is food being digested? The food is being digested or broken down into small particles that can be absorbed. Focus on absorption. Having defined the term digestion, we need to move on and look at the parts of the digestive system. Digestive is a system. Being a system, that means that it comprises some parts, it has some components. The parts need to be mentioned in their order, starting from the first to the last part. The first part of digestion, we do have mouth. Mouth is the first part of digestion because for you to get food into your body, the food must be taken through the mouth. The mouth. Mouth from the first part, then second part after mouth, we do have what we call esophagus. What is the other name of esophagus? Esophagus is also known as what? Gut. Thirdly, from esophagus, we go to stomach. From stomach, we have what I'm calling small intestines. From small intestine, I will have what we call large intestines. From large intestine, we go to rectum. Then lastly, the last part of digestion, we do have what we call anus. Those are the part of the digestive system. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That's 7 parts. You need to know them and you need to arrange them in order from the first to the last. These parts all together collectively, they form a tube-like passage. It's just like a tube, just like a pipe running from the mouth to the anus. These parts are located along that pipe. How do you call that pipe? Or how do you call all these parts collectively together? this part that known as alimentary canal. Alimentary canal is the pipe passing from the mouth to anus. We have this part along it. As you pass from the mouth to the anus, you will find this part. First, you have mouth, esophagus, stomach. After stomach, small intestine. From small intestine, large intestine, rectum, and then anus. All of them together, they give us what we call alimentary canal. Now, let's look at the parts. Let's discuss this part one after the other, and let's look at what happens at each part. The first part we see is mouth. We need to discuss mouth. The first part is mouth. What do you have in mouth? What is taking place in the mouth? This is the thing we need to look at. In the mouth, we do have 15, very crucial indication. In the mouth, we do have 15. What role do they play in relation to digestion? Teeth help to break down food into small particles by the act of chewing. Just say teeth chew foods into small particles. There is the mouth, apart from that, you do have the tongue. What is the role of tongue in digestion? What function does it play as far as digestion becomes fun? You discover that when you produce particles, when you produce something in the mouth and you start chewing, the tongue has got some behaviors. How does it behave? The tongue moves up and down, up and down. That movement of the tongue up and down when you're chewing food help to mix food with digestive juice in the mouth. The movement also help to roll food into small balls called boluses. The movement also, when you're chewing, the tongue moves up and down, also help to push food the back of the mouth for easy swallowing. So to start with, tongue help to roll food into small balls called boluses. Tongue, I also say, tongue's help to mix food with digestive juice in the mouth. That is what? Saliva. The movement of the tongue up and down, we agree, that also help to push food. To the back of the mouth. And here, no one will put his hand or fingers to push the food to the back of the mouth. This is swallowing. It's the function of the tongue. As it moves up and down, it pushes that boluses into the back of the mouth for easy swallowing. That's all about the tongue. Thirdly, we do have the last part in the mouth. Mouth, we do have what? Saliva. We do have saliva. Saliva is produced in salivary glands. Salivary glands are the ones produce saliva. And what is the function of saliva in digestion? The function of saliva, number one, talk about lubricate. Saliva lubricate food. Lubrication. What is the meaning of that lubricate or lubricating? What does it mean? To lubricate something is to make it slippery so that it can slide easily into the mouth. So let's talk about lubricating to make slippery for easy swallowing. Then saliva also, it is watery. It helps to moisten. Saliva helps to moisten food. Remember, when you're swallowing, you don't need to swallow dry foods. You need something that is a bit moistened for easy swallowing. Saliva, being a digestive juice, helps digest food. Digest food. And which type of food is digested in the mouth. Saliva helps digest food and specifically it digests starch. Starch is found in energy-giving food. These are carbohydrates. That is all about the mouth. This is how you describe the mouth, and this is how you describe the digestion of the mouth. Digestion of the mouth, remember, you target the three parts, the crucial part. Number one, talk about the teeth. Number two, tongue. And lastly, talk about saliva. And remember to mention what roles each part plays in digestion. After mouth, our second part. After mouth, our second part will be oesophagus. Our oesophagus. This is also called gut. Here, in oesophagus, there is no much activities taking place here. There is no digestion. There is no production of energies. There is no juice produced here. No more activity. What is happening here is simply passage of food. The movement of food from the mouth down to the stomach. It is through the oesophagus. And here, food moves in a wave-like manner. It doesn't just drop, no. It moves in a wave-like manner. And if you have watched snake, those people who like watching documentary channels on TV, if a snake swallows things, the things move in a wave-like manner. That's how food moves down the oesophagus into the stomach. The movement of food in oesophagus, we call it peristalsis. This is how food moves. This is a wave-like move. A wave-like movement in the oesophagus. After oesophagus, another part, the second part of oesophagus, we have stomach. We do have stomach. Stomach is a stack-like container that helps to contain food during the digestion process. So from oesophagus, food gets into the stomach, where it stays for a period of 3 to 4 hours. And the food will leave stomach once it has been digested. And at that time, the food we say it is in a molten state. Just like porridge, how the porridge occurs, that's the molten state. Here in the stomach, we have so many things to discuss about the stomach and digestion in the stomach. But in primary content, we are going to be brief, we are going to be narrow towards the required of us. We are going to look at stomach. They just produce the stomach and their function, that is it. So in the stomach, we have a production of food digestive juices. Number one, we have gastric juice. Gastric juice produced by the wall of the stomach. What is the function of gastric juice? Gastric juice helps to break down some food in small particles, and this food is called all proteins. Gastric juice act or deal with protein. Their function is just to digest protein. Hence, digestion of proteins starts in the stomach. Then they take it to the mouth, they pass the esophagus, and they start digestion. Then digestion will start in the stomach. It's where they will be broken down into small particles. Again, the wall of stomach also produces what we call hydrochloric acid. In short, it's called HCl. Hydrochloric acid. What is the function of hydrochloric acid? Their function is to kill germs. To kill germs that may be in food. So that when you take something down there, it is safe and free from germs. Stomach, we have seen, we have juices being produced. Where else? We mentioned juice, remember? We mentioned juice in the mouth. Now we are mentioning juice in the stomach. So far, guys, there is no production of any juice. You take note of that. In the stomach, we have gastric juice produced by the wall of the stomach. And we have hydrochloric acid produced purposely to kill germs that might be in food. So that when you take something down to the next part, it is free from germs. That is all about stomach. At your level, then from stomach, immediately from the stomach, we go to another part that we call it small intestines. Small intestine. What is the name of small intestine? Small intestine is also known as ileum. But this part is the longest part of the digestive system. It is approximately 7 meters in length. Why is it long? Why is it that long? It is long to give room for enough digestion and also to give room for enough absorption of digested foods. It is long, so one would wonder, my name is saying it is long, 7 meters, and I'm less than 2 meters. For example, my height, I'm less than 2 meters. Then how comes this 7 meter? Malik was thinking about fit the stomach. It fits the stomach because it is coiled in this manner. But when you stretch it, it is taller than the alum. What happens here? Immediately from the stomach, we go to the small intestine. Small intestine is divided into two parts. We have the upper part and the lower part, or the first part and the last part. The upper part comes immediately when you leave the stomach. When you leave the stomach, you go to the first part of the small intestine, and this first part of small intestine, we do call it duodenum. The first part, or the upper part of small intestine, is called duodenum. Where is duodenum located? Immediately from the stomach. When you leave the stomach, you go to the first part, which is called duodenum. What is the function of duodenum in digestion? Remember, duodenum does not. Take note of that. Duodenum does not produce any juice. Duodenum is just a recipient to receive juices from other parts of the body. Duodenum receives first, received by juice. It receives by juice. Received by juice from where? Received by juice produced by the liver. By juice produced in the liver and stored in the gallbladder. Now from the gallbladder, it will be taken to duodenum. To do what? To break down fats. To break down fats and oils into lipids. Duodenum does not, I'm repeating, and I'm putting strong emphasis there, take note of that. Duodenum does not produce energies. It just received by juice from the liver. This juice is produced in the liver, by juice. And remember, liver is not part of the alimentary canal. It's not part of the digestive system. Liver is just other part that assists in digestion by producing by juice. And again, it receives another juice called pancreatic juice. This analogy is called pancreatic disease. Where does it receive pancreatic disease from? Pancreatic disease is produced in pancreas. Just the word suggests where it is produced. Pancreatic disease is produced in pancreas. What is the function of this disease? The function of this disease is to further break down foods. Into small particles. The function of pancreatic disease is to break down all foods. This, it is not selective like the one we discussed in the mouth that digs on the starch, and the one we discussed the stomach that acts on proteins. This one further breaks down all foods.
Then from there, food moves to the lower part of small intestine, or the second part of the small intestine, which is we call it what? Ileum. Ileum wall produces now. Ileum will produce last digestive juice.
Ileum produces the last digestive juice called intestinal juice. This is the last digestive juice. Where is it produced? It's produced in ileum. Another the function of this juice, the function of this juice is to complete intestinal juice. Completes. So where is the digestion completed? Digestion is completed in intestinal, in the ileum or small intestine. The function of this juice is just to complete, to finish up the whole process of digestion. This digestion is completed. Digestion is completed in what? Ileum. If there's no ileum, then go to the broader house, which is small intestine. Now the ileum wall has the finger-like projection. This finger-like projection we call it villi. Villi are finger-like projection. And when we talk about the digestive system, some of us we are very much conversant with these parts. When I talk about the intestines, these are edible parts of the animals. We feed on animals, and these parts that are edible. We talk about the intestine, we talk about matumbo, we talk about the villi here, we talk about the towel part of the matumbo, something appearing like spongy, like a towel. These are called the villi. They have finger-like projection. This projection, the villi, they are very crucial when you talk about absorption. Now we have villi, we do have blood capillaries. Very many blood capillaries coming. Very many blood capillaries. Remember, when we are talking about the blood capillaries, there is something I discussed about blood capillary in class 7. And I have started the topic human body, we shall capture it again. Blood capillaries are very key. And they give room, because of their thin nature, they give room for extended materials. Here is your absorption that comes in now. They are very thin to allow material to move from the small intestine or ileum by the help of the villi. The material move now from the small intestine into the blood vessels. And the blood vessels we are talking about, these are the capillaries. That the material moving, but remember the blood does not come out of the vessels. We shall talk that, we shall discuss that under this content. You'll know there's movement of food in and out, but here specifically we talk about movement of foods from the digestive system into the blood through the help of villains. Hence, digested food is absorbed in what? Small intestine or ileum. Ileum help in absorption. Another part after ileum, we looked at large, we mentioned large intestine. Large intestine, they are also known as all of them. There is no more activities here. There is no more digestion because we say that digestion is completed in small intestine. Completed means it is done. No more digestion. Here there is no digestion. There is no production of energies. What you have here is just absorption. And here, large intestine help to absorb mineral salt. And water into the blood. Then the solid food that remains, remember we have absorbed minerals, have absorbed water. The solid food that is not digested remains, it's taken to rectum, where it is stored temporarily and taken out of the body through anus. That is all about digestion. I will give you some few questions to discuss the whole process and some few questions from meta science. At the end of the digestion in meta, I have some exercise there for you. You try to do it and take good use of this time, our candidate. Remember, as a school, we do have a target. As a candidate, individually, there at home, you do have your target. For you to achieve your target, you need to take advantage of this situation. You have given more time, make good use of it. So that by that time you sit for KCP, you will have revised and revised and revised all areas that is tested in exam. Thank you and God bless you.